Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to explain you about Selenium basics, how to automate these checkboxes and radio buttons in the web page as part of Selenium beginner tutorials. So let's get started. So what is the checkboxes and radio buttons in the web page? So HTML checkboxes are the simple fields that can be toggled on or off using a mouse click, and the radio buttons are used to select one, we can select only one option in the menu. Whereas checkboxes, we can select all the options, but whereas in the radio buttons, we can check only one option. So let's begin into our Eclipse coding and we'll see how can we automate these checkboxes and radio buttons. And these radio buttons and checkboxes are mostly available in our web pages and in application. One or other form, we have these checkboxes or radio buttons. And to get good conditions on this checkboxes and radio buttons, I will show you one by one on this radio buttons and checkboxes. So let's jump into our Chrome browser. So this is my form which has a checkboxes here. So it has three checkboxes. So I will try to create XPath for one of the checkboxes here. So let me inspect this using a right click and inspect. And here I can see here I have this input tag, and under input tag it is having type as checkboxes, because any checkboxes in the web page that will be given type as a checkbox, and that will provide additional values like name, value, and even the label text. So here I wanted to take this. I have a bike XPath, so let me right click and copy an XPath. This is the simplest way. We no need to write again here. So I can directly go to the HTML tag and right click and go to copy. Under copy, we can see we have different options like our copy selector, copy JS path, copy styles, XPath, full XPath. I have copied XPath. Let's see what I have copied XPath. So it is a absolute XPath. So I don't want absolute XPath because it is copied absolute XPath. So I wanted to relay to XPath. So how can we write the relay to XPath? Double forward slash. So tag is input, and under input tag we have what is the difference in those checkboxes. You need to find uniqueness in the XPath so that it will select only one option. So it has only uniqueness on the value. So I will copy the value attribute and attribute value as bike. So let me copy this, and in the input I will provide @value equal to, this is my option, V is capital here. I need to provide V capital. Let me copy from here. Okay, I use curly braces instead of square braces, so that is the reason I am not able to identify the XPath. So now we have one of one XPath. Let's copy this XPath and jump into our Eclipse. So here I have Selenium project, which is already created. In case if you are new to this tutorial, please do watch my previous tutorials where I have explained about how to create the Selenium projects and some basics of Selenium. And in this project I have this package called basic Selenium. So under that I will create a new package called basic Selenium 5, and we need a main method too. So check this main method. And before we begin the actual coding for this option, I will set the system set properties and browser initiation. So for that I will do system.setProperty. So set property uses string key and key value. So string key I can provide web driver, all in the lowercase. We should not use the uppercase, then it will throw an error. Web driver dot chrome.driver, and my key value is my exe file location. So in this project I am maintaining one folder which is a server. Under that I have this all the exe files. I will go to this Chrome properties and I will copy the location of that exe file. In the value I will paste this value, And now we are ready with system set properties. Now we need to initiate the browser using WebDriver. Driver equal to new Chrome driver. Now we are ready with system set properties and browser initiation. Now we need to launch the website using a driver.get method. Driver.get. Under get, I will provide the my URL. So here I have this URL. I will provide the same URL. And I am using my HTML file. You can use your website link here. And I wanted to create a web element. Web element equal to checkbox one equal to driver dot find element by dot xpath. So under xpath, I will paste this xpath which we have identified in the web page. Double quotation, and now we are ready with. So far we have created system set properties, browser initiation, and the launching a website, and the creating a web element using a XPath. Now I will try to perform an action on this checkbox. I will perform a click action dot click, so that it will click the checkbox, and I will say driver dot quit, so that it will quit the browser. Let me launch this program and let me run this program quickly. Now it has launched the website, and I think it is not waiting for any time. So I will comment this line. I will comment this driver quit, and again relaunch this program again. So here you can see this option has been selected. The first option which we have created for a web element, that option has been selected. In case if there is any requirement we want to select all the checkboxes in the form. So for that, how can we write the XPath and how can we handle those? So I will show you now how can we select all the checkboxes here. So here this input tag and type is checkbox. So I will take input tag and type as checkbox. Type equal to this checkbox. So now you can see here I have one of three items. So it means it is taking all the items in this XPath. So I will copy this XPath and come back to my actual Eclipse, and here I will try to create list. So list. So list of web elements, and I will say this as list equal to driver dot find element, and here we need to use find elements, not the find elements. In case if you use list with find element, it will throw us an exception. So you need to make sure you use find elements. XPath, and my XPath value is this. Now we have created a list here. Let me take this out here from here. So let me comment this line. So now we have taken the list of checkboxes. So I wanted to select all the checkboxes which are under my list. So for that, I will use for loop or for each loop. In the for each, I will say web element web element, and I will iterate this list, and I will say element. For every web element, I will try to perform click action. I will say click. So now it is, till now we have created the list of all the checkboxes, and we are iterating using for each, and we are trying to select one by one checkbox using a element or click, which is a web element which is trying to iterate this list items. I will run this program again. it has launched a web page. Now you can see it has selected our checkboxes in the form. So there is one checkbox which is got unchecked, because it is by default it is checked. So I wanted to select all the checkboxes, but here it is already checked and my web driver is doing the click event on the checkbox. So if any checkbox is already checked, if I wanted to perform again click event, then that checkbox will go to unchecked. So to handle this kind of situation, I will show you one method where we can perform such actions. So here I wanted to try if my element dot is selected. So I have this is select. So if my element is selected, then I will say system dot print. So I wanted to print that my element is already been selected, and I will remove this from here, and I will say else. The else part I will say element to click. So in the system dot system out dot println, I will say checkbox is already selected. So which checkbox is selected, I wanted to know which checkbox is selected. For that I will say element dot get text. So this will get the text of that particular checkbox. So I will use this same command in the else part as well, where I will say checkbox is selected now. I will use same driver dot, I mean element dot get text, so it will get the text. So here I'm using list of checkboxes and iterating using a for each, and for each I'm using the if condition, where if my checkbox is already selected, I wanted to try this, I mean I wanted to ignore those checkboxes and check those checkboxes which are not selected. So let me again quickly run this program. Here you can see all the checkboxes has been selected, and previously we have seen one checkbox got unchecked. So now you can see all the checkboxes got checked, and even in the console logs you can see checkbox has been selected. I think get text is not getting the value. We can use instead of get text, I can use get attribute. Get attribute, and my attribute should fetch the value of the attribute. And similarly, I will use here get attribute. My attribute has value. I want to fetch the attribute value. So let me rerun the program again. Okay, now we can see, so these are the options that already, I mean that are selected now, which is bike, car, and the option which is already selected, it is a boat. So this is how we can perform different operations using a web driver on the checkboxes. Now we'll see how can we perform actions on the radio buttons. So let me show you the radio buttons HTML as well. So radio buttons. So here I have this radio buttons. I wanted to perform click action. So for this radio buttons, I cannot do all multiple options to be checked. So I can perform only one option. So you cannot do multiple selections on the radio buttons. You can select only one option here. So here I wanted to select this gender type. So to select the gender type, I will use this value where we have this input and we have ID also to maintain the uniqueness in the radio buttons. So I can directly use this ID. So ID equal to male. So I will jump into Eclipse program again. So I will make uncomment all this checkboxes code. Now I will say driver to launch. This is a checkbox related code. So I wanted to launch now radio buttons related code. So driver dot get, so under string I will use this radio buttons reference. Now I wanted to perform and click action on this radio button, which is a mail. So I will take ID as mail and I will jump into here and I will say driver dot find element by dot ID, and in the ID I will provide this option. I can perform click action. So this is a normal and generic way. I mean, this is the simplest way to use this approach, where we are trying to find the web element using ID and we are performing click action. So let me quickly run this program and see whether our radio buttons is getting selected or not. So it has launched a web service. Yeah, it has checked the mail option. So I wanted to iterate, I wanted to select one more radio button in this list of ages between this 31 to 60. I will inspect that checkbox now. I mean radio button now. So it is using ID as age 2. So I will use this ID as age 2, and here I will say driver dot find element by dot ID, and my ID is age 2 dot click. And ID is the best way to use, because ID uses very faster in the web page in the HTML DOM, and you can use ID for getting, I mean, which will get the web element in very less time when compared to others like XPath and CSS. Let me run the program again. For age, it is not getting selected. So we'll see why it is not getting selected. So it has thrown an error. Let's see. Okay, I am using the clear here, so I need to use click. So if you use the wrong method, it will throw an exception. Yeah, now you can see this is how we can perform actions using actions on the radio buttons. So in case if I wanted to know, I wanted to see if my radio buttons are being already selected or not, I want to see those options are selected. In case if it is selected, I don't want to perform again click action and I wanted to proceed further. So for in those situations, what I will do, I will take this as web element equal to radio 1, and similarly I will do for the ages as well. Web element radio 2. Now we have web elements created for this IDs, and I wanted to perform these radio buttons are already selected. In case if those are selected, ignore them, and if it is not selected, click on select option. So I will say if my radio 1 dot is selected, then I will say system dot print radio 1 dot get attribute and attribute as value, radio button is selected. In case if it is not selected, I wanted to perform else part, I wanted to select that option if it is not selected. I will say radio 1 dot is selected dot click event, and here I will try to print system dot print dot ln, and I wanted to say this option, I wanted to use this similar text here. I want to say radio button is selected now. So let me save this program and quickly run. Now you can see console log, it says male radio button is selected now, so which means it is not selected earlier, so it is selected now. So let me do one more condition, add one more condition like radio one dot click. So I wanted to perform click action, and after that I will try to check for the condition is selected. Let me rerun again, so it will again launch the web browser and launch the application URL. In console logs, you can see male option radio button is already selected because I have selected that option. I am trying to see is radio button is selected or not. So this is how we can perform automation on the checkboxes and radio buttons. And in case if you are new to this tutorial, please do watch my previous tutorials where we have discussed related to visibility of web element, which deals about what, how can we use this is selected, is enabled and is displayed methods that are most useful and very handy when we are trying to automate these checkboxes and radio buttons. Thank you for watching, and in case if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share your questions, queries in the comment section.